Hi guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you another beautiful project. This time it will be table runner or even tablecloth by joining square motifs. My project, basically one motif, is measured about 8 inches, so a little bit less than 8 inches. I am crocheting quite loosely, so your square can be a little bit smaller. I am using crochet hook size 1.5 millimeters and the thread similar to size 10, 280 meters of a thread equals about 50 gram. So in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to crochet this motif and how to join them together, this square of course. And I would like to thank you very much to all my patrons and to all my members of YouTube channel for your donations, for your support. If you not a member or patron of my channel yet and you are quite interested, you can find the link to both, to YouTube membership or to Patreon, just in the comment section under this tutorial. So by become a member of a YouTube channel or a member of my Patreon site, you will be able to have access to more video tutorials. So one more time, thank you very much, and now we can start our work. We are going to start by making slip knot, then chain of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Slip stitch in first chain stitch to form a ring, and we are going to start the first round. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, and now into the ring, into our circle, we have to make another 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Now chain of 4, then 4 double crochets into the circle, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain of 4, then another group of 4 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Chain of 4, and now the last one, group of 4 double crochets. So in our circle we should have 4 groups of 4 double crochets. After each group we need to make chain of 4. So now this is our fourth one. 1, 2, 3 and 4. And at the end we have to work slip stitch at the top of chain 3. So in our first double crochet. So this is our first round. Second round we have to start again by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space. Now we have to skip the next 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet into the third one. Now chain 2, double crochet in chain 4 space, chain of 4 and double crochet in the same chain space. Chain of 2, double crochet in first double crochet, chain 2, then we have to skip next 2 double crochets, double crochet in third double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in fourth in chain 4 space, then chain of 4 again. So at the, when we are exactly at the corner, We have to work in each chain for space, double crochet, chain 4, and then one more double crochet. Then chain of 2, double crochet in first double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in last double crochet, chain of 2, and again in chain 4 space double crochet, chain 4, and then double crochet, chain of 2, then double crochet in first double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in last double crochet, chain of 2, and we've got our last corner, so double crochet, chain 4, and then double crochet, chain of 2, and now we have to work slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. So on each side we should have 3 open squares, and at each corner, we should have chain 4 spaces. So in each corner, in each chain 4 space from our previous round, we've done double crochet, chain 4, and double crochet, then 3 open squares. Round number 3, we have to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain of 2 as a chain 2 space. Double crochet in next double crochet, then again chain of 2 and double crochet in next double crochet. So at the moment we've got 2 open squares. In our chain 4 space at the corner we have to make 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Then chain of 4 again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then another 3 double crochets in the same chain space. 1, 2 and 3. And now double crochet in next double crochet. So by working this way on both sides of our chain 4 space, we've got groups of 4 double crochets. Now chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, then double crochet in next double crochet. So on each side we should have 3 open squares, the same as we've done in our previous one. So this is mean that at the end we have to make extra open square at the end, and then slip stitch in chain, in third chain of our first double crochet. And now we've got chain 4, and we have to start with 3 double crochets, chain of 4, and then another 3 double crochets. Double crochet in next double crochet, then we have to make another 3 open squares as we've done on this side. So the same pattern now we have to repeat all the way around. So on each side we should have 3 open squares, and at the each corner we should have 3 double crochets, chain 4, and then 3 double crochets. Round number 4, we have to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet again, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space. Now double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, and double crochet in next double crochet. So we've got 2 open squares at the beginning, and now we have to make 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 2, double crochet in chain 4 space, then chain of 4, then double crochet in the same chain space. So we've got some kind of V-stitch at the corner again. Double crochet, chain 4, and double crochet. Now chain of 2, then double crochet into the first double crochet. So before and after each corner we should have 1 open square. Now 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, 1, 2 and 3, and now you have to make 3 open squares again. So chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, and then in next 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 2, then into the chain 4 space again. Double crochet, chain 4 and 1 more double crochet. Chain of 2, double crochet in first double crochet and then in next 3. So this is our whole pattern. Now we have to repeat this all the way around. So now we have to make 1 double crochet in next 3 double crochets, then 3 open squares. So exactly as we've got here. At the end we need to work the last open square and then slip stitch in third chain stitch. Now we are going to start round number 5. So chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space, double crochet in next double crochet, and now chain of 3 and into the next 4 double crochets we have to work 4 double crochets together. So in each stitch we need to make only the first part of the double crochet. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 3, then double crochet in next double crochet, and in our chain 4 space now we have to make 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3, then chain of 4, so we are exactly at the corner again, and 3 double crochets. So the same pattern as we've done 2 runs before. One, two, three, and double crochet in next double crochet. So on both sides of our chain 4 space, we've got a group of 4 double crochets. Now chain of 3. Four double crochets together again. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now 5 loops we can finish the stitch. Chain of 3, so before 4 double crochets together and after always we have to work chain 3, double crochet in next double crochet, then chain of 2 and double crochet in next one. And basically in this round we've got 1 proper open square, then on both sides of our open square we need to work chain of 3. 1, 2, 3, then we've got another group of 4 double crochets, so 4 double crochets together. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 3 again. Double crochet in next double crochet, then in chain 4 space 3 double crochets, chain 4 and another 3 double crochets. So now this pattern we have to repeat all the way around. 1 open square, chain 3 spaces on both sides of our 4 double crochets together, and at the corner in chain 4 space we have to make 3 double crochets, chain 4, and then another 3 double crochets. Round number 6. Now we have to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space and double crochet in next double crochet. Now chain 2, double crochet in chain 3 space, chain of 2, double crochet in next chain 3 space, so group of 4 double crochets together we have to skip, chain of 2, then 1 double crochet in next 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now chain of 2 again, then in chain 4 space double crochet, chain 4, and one more double crochet. Chain 2 and again 1 double crochet in next 4 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, and 4, then chain of 2, double crochet in chain 3 space, chain 2. Then we have to skip group of 4 double crochets, double crochet in next chain 3 space, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet. Chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next chain 3 space, chain 2, then double crochet in next chain 3 space again, so chain then now group of 4 double crochets together all the time you have to skip, chain of 2, and now 1 double crochet in next 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So now on each side we have to work only with open squares, so when we've got a chain of 3 we have to work double crochet in chain 3 space, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 open squares in the middle, then group of 4 double crochets, 1 open square before or after our corner, and at the corner again double crochet, chain 4 and double crochet. And the same pattern now we have to repeat all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 7 by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space. Double crochet in next double crochet, then chain 2 and double crochet into the next one. Chain of 2, double crochet in next, so our round we just started by making 3 open squares. Now chain of 3 and into the next 4 double crochets we have to work 4 double crochets together. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5 loops we can finish the stitch, chain of 3 again, then double crochet in next double crochet. Now we are exactly at the corner, so in chain 4 space we have to make 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3, chain of 4, and another 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3. Double crochet in next double crochet. So as you can see, the pattern is very similar to our pattern from round number 5. Only one difference is that we are going to have more open squares in the middle on each side. So now chain of 3, then 4 double crochets together in next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 loops, you can finish the stitch, chain of 3, then double crochet in next double crochet. And now we are going to make 5 open squares. So chain of 2 and double crochet in each next double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, chain of 3, then into the next group of 4 double crochets we have to work 4 double crochets again. 2, 3 and 4, chain of 3, then double crochet, next double crochet, and again we are at the corner. So in chain 4 space we have to make 3 double crochets, chain 4 and another 3 double crochets. And this pattern we are going to repeat all the way around. At the end we have to add another last 2 open squares, of course. We've got only 3 at the beginning, and then slip stitch in our third chain stitch of the first double crochet. Now we are going to start round number 8. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space. Double crochet in next double crochet, so we've got open square again. Chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in chain 3 space. Chain of 2, now we have to skip 4 double crochets together and double crochet in next chain 3 space. Chain of 2, 1 double crochet in next 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4, chain of 2, then in chain 4 space we have to make double crochet, chain 4, then one more double crochet. Chain of 2, double crochet in next 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4, chain of 2, double crochet in chain 3 space, chain 2, now we have to skip next group of 4 double crochets together and we need to make double crochet in next chain 3 space. Chain of 2, double crochet in next one, chain 2, double crochet in next, chain 2, double crochet in next one, chain 2, double crochet in next, chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, then double crochet in next, chain of 2, double crochet in chain 3 space, chain 2, double crochet in next chain 3 space. So again, 4 double crochets together we have to skip, chain of 2 and 1 double crochet in next 4 double crochets. So from now we can repeat our pattern in exactly the same way as we've done from the beginning. So we need to make chain 2 and then in our chain 4 space double crochet, chain 4 and double crochet. So On each side we should have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 open squares and then 1 before and after each corner. Now we are going to start round number 9. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space. Double crochet in next double crochet. Chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet. Chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet. Chain 2, double crochet in next one. Chain 2, double crochet in next double crochet. Now chain of 3. In our group of 4 double crochets together, we have 4 double crochets. We need to make 4 double crochets together. 2, 3 and 4. Because this is the last one round with our leaves, in this round we have to make chain of 3, double crochet in next double crochet, and instead of making another group of 3 double crochets, we are going to make chain of 2, then in chain 4 space double crochet, chain 4 and then double crochet. Now again, chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, chain of 3 and 4 double crochets together in next 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain of 3, double crochet in next double crochet, chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet, 1, chain of 2, double crochet in next, chain of 2, double crochet in next double crochet. And now we have to repeat working with open squares until the next group of 4 double crochets. So after the last double crochet here, we have to make chain of 3, then group of 4 double crochets together, chain 3, and we need to repeat what we've done from the beginning. And then I will go back to you at the beginning of next round. Now we've got the next round, round number 10. And after slip stitch in our third chain stitch, so at the top of our first double crochet, now we have to make chain of 1, then single crochet in the same double crochet. Chain of 2, then single crochet in next double crochet. Chain 2, single crochet in next double crochet. Chain 2, single crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, single crochet in next double crochet. So basically the same pattern now, you have to repeat all the way across. Chain of 2, single crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, then single crochet in chain 3 space. So after single crochet in our double crochet, chain 2, single crochet in next chain space, then chain of 2 and single crochet in next double crochet. So we have to skip our group of 4 double crochets together, just above we need to work chain 2 space. Now chain of 2, single crochet in next double crochet, chain 2, single crochet at the corner in chain 4 space, chain of 2, then one more single crochet in the same chain space. Chain of 2, single crochet in double crochet, chain 2, then single crochet in next double crochet. So at the corner in chain 4 space, basically we have to work 2 single crochets and chain 2 space. So in the double crochet, then 2 in chain 4 space, and then into the next double crochet again. Now chain of 2, single crochet in chain 3 space, chain of 2, now we have to skip 4 double crochets together, single crochet in next one, chain of 2, then single crochet in next double crochet. Chain of 2, single crochet in next double crochet, and the same pattern as we've done from the beginning. Now we have to repeat all the way around. So on the top of each open square we should have chain 2 space, 1 single crochet in each double crochet in each chain 3 space, and 2 single crochets plus chain 2 at each corner. Now we are going to start working on our last one round, round number 11. So now we need to start by making chain of 2 instead of the first part of the double crochet. Then in our first chain 2 space we have to make again first part of the double crochet. So we are going to work only through first 2 loops, and the last loop need to stay on the hook. Then half double crochet in next single crochet. When we've got 3 loops on the hook, we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 4, and we are going to work picot. So we have to insert crochet hook in all our 3 loops as we've done before, and then make slip knot. Now chain of 3, then we are going to skip chain 2 space and 1 single crochet in single crochet. Chain of 3, then we have to skip another chain 2 space, and into the next single crochet we have to make first part of the double crochet, then first part of the double crochet in chain 2 space, then in next single crochet. Now 4 loops we can finish the stitch, chain of 4, then slip stitch through all 4 loops. Chain 3. Now again we have to skip first chain 2 space, single crochet in next single crochet, chain of 3, skip the next chain 2 space and first part of the double crochet in next single crochet, then into the chain 2 space and in next single crochet. 4 loops we can finish the stitch. Now chain of 4, then slip stitch through all 4 loops. Chain of 3. Now we have to again skip chain 2 space, single crochet in next single crochet, chain 3, then in next single crochet again we have to make first part of the double crochet, then in next chain 2 space first part of the double crochet, and into the next one again. So 4 loops we can finish the stitch, chain of 4, slip stitch through all 4 loops, chain of 3, and now we should be exactly at the corner. So we've got chain 2 space in our chain 4 where we've done 2 single crochets, and now we need to make single crochet in our chain 2 space, chain 3 again. And in next single crochet, so this is the second single crochet in our corner, we have to make first part of the double crochet, then in chain 2 space first part of the double crochet, and then in next single crochet first part of the double crochet. 4 loops we can finish the stitch, chain of 4, and slip stitch through all 4 loops. Now chain of 3, and again, now we need to skip chain 2 space, single crochet in next single crochet, chain of 3, skip the next chain 2 space, and in next single crochet first part of the double crochet, then first part of the double crochet in next chain 2 space, and in next single crochet. So now for loops we can finish the stitch. We just started exactly by making 3 double crochets together, then we need to skip next two chain two spaces, and in each third chain two space we have to work groups of three double crochets together. So by making first one in single crochet, second in chain two space, and the third one in next single crochet. At the corner, our first group of four double crochets we have to finish on our first single crochet. Then we need to make single crochet in chain space, and the second group we have to start, or the next actually group we have to start from the second single crochet, still in our chain four space. And now the same pattern we have to repeat all the way around. So make sure that in each third chain two space you've got, actually on the top of each chain two space, third chain two space, you've got group of three double crochets together, and at the end we should have chain four, single crochet in our last single crochet, then chain of four and slip stitch at the top of our group of three double crochets together. Then we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So this will be our first square. By using this one round, we are going to join another ones. So only in our first square, just finish this round. Later on, we are going to make only the first part of the first side, and then by using the second one we are going to start joining the squares together. So in a minute I will go back to you to show you how we need to join the squares together. So my first square I've done to the end, so the last one around is actually finished, and now we need to start joining our squares together. We are start making the second row, because in first row we've got two squares, and then in second one we've got three. So basically I'm just first of all would like to make the longer part, and then I will add extra first row, then the third one. As you saw already on the picture at the beginning of my tutorial, I am using different colors of squares. So if you would like to make in exactly the same way, just make the second square in different color. And basically in our first row, this is the second one, but we are making it as a first, we are joining only one side. So we can, I've done so far 2.5 sides, and then the same we can work with the third square as well. So if you are joining in a first row, here we can join in exactly the same way, because we have to skip the first place and we are going to the second one. We are joining only one side, but with the second one will be a little bit more complicated, because we need to join the bottom part and the side part as well. So we need to leave two sides undone. At the moment I'm going to show you how to join the first two squares together, and basically each next square we have to join in exactly the same way, and basically we need to just repeat the pattern as I've done before. Or if you are working with one color, it will be even easier. So the second row got three squares, the first one you've got only two, the third got three squares, but we are start joining from the second, third, and then the fourth one is a extra, and the fourth one got only two squares. So if you are not quite sure how to join, how the joining supposed to looks like, just go back to the beginning of a tutorial and see the picture. And now, as I said, I am just at the corner. I've done first group of three double crochets together after my corner, and now we have to start making chain of two. Now we need to grab our first square, and we are going to the first picot after corner on our bottom side. We have to insert crochet hook into the picot, make a slip stitch, then another chain of two, and slip stitch to make a picot at the top of our group of 3 double crochets in second corner. So pattern staying exactly the same. Now chain of 3, then we need to skip chain 2 space and single crochet in next single crochet, chain of 3, then we have to skip next chain 2 space and another group of 3 double crochets together. So first part in single crochet, then in chain 2 space and into the next single crochet. And now for loops we can finish the stitch. Now again chain of 2, then we have to find second picot in our first square, slip stitch, chain of 2 and slip stitch at the top of our group of 3 double crochets together. Then chain of 3, single crochet in next single crochet, chain 3 and another group of 3 double crochets. So we have to skip chain 2 space, first part in single crochet, then in chain 2 space and then in next single crochet. So basically the joining is very easy. We have to join only the picots together. So we are starting from the first one on each side and we have to finish with the last one. Then in exactly the same way we have to join the other squares. So from the first one to the last one. So now if we are 10, I will work to the proper in a way. We've got white, I've got blue and then another white. So if you are working with two different colors the same as I, you need to follow the pattern to make sure that we are joining the proper squares. So now the first row here we need to start with the white one and then the blue or the color as you choose before.